The next circuit is the carry look ahead adder. In this adder, we are trying to reduce the delay associated with the carry. The delay in the addition that we have seen with the binary adder is due to the carry bit. Since every full adder has to wait for the carry input from its previous full adder, it is going to take 3 units of time for every full adder to give the carry to the next bit. So this is how we incur the delay. To avoid the delay, if we are able to generate the carry as soon as we supply the inputs, then it is easy to predict the carry and then add those inputs together all at a time. So this is the principle of carry look ahead adder. So this is the full adder circuit that we have already seen. So here we are going to use two terms, the carry propagate term and this is carry generate term. And this PI and GI will be able to generate as soon as we supply the inputs. So if we supply the input at time t0, we are able to get this output at time t1. Now this is the sum output, which is PI XORed with the next carry, which is CI, and the carry for this will be actually PI CA, which is the multiplication of these two things, and or GI, the previous carry or the carry by adding the first two bits. We try to express the carry to the next bit in terms of this carry propagate and carry generate, and this we can use it recursively to generate the carry ahead of its generation from the previous full adder circuit. These are the equations that we have from the circuit. Carry propagate is XOR of AI and BI, carry generation is AI BI, and sum is XOR of PI and CI. The next carry bit is GI or PI CI. Now we can use this equation of the carry to generate the carries of all the bits. To start with, the carry is 0, that is the C0 is 0, and C1 is G0 plus P0 C0. Simply substitute I is equal to 1. Okay, so we get, we are trying to compute C1. So C1 will be I plus 1 is 1. So I will be 0. So we compute C1 equal to G0 or P0 C0. That's what we have here. Now we can compute C2 similarly. So C2 will be G1 plus P1 C1. And what is C1? We can substitute for C1 and get C2 as G1 or P1 G0 or P1 P0 P0. Similarly, we can compute C3 by substituting for C2 and multiplying and get this long expression. And this expression will grow as the carries increases, that is the number of bits that we wanted to add increases. But the trick is that how we can implement this equations of the carries. If we are able to get AND gates which can accept any number of inputs and generate its output, then this equations can be implemented in two levels. We'll have one AND gate which has 4 inputs. This is another AND gate that accepts 3 inputs, and this is another AND gate which accepts 2 inputs and produces all the products at level 1, and the output of all the AND gates together with G2 we can supply to a single OR gate. So the OR gate is going to accept 3 or 4 inputs in the case of C3, and the OR gate will accept 3 inputs in the case of C2 and so on. So if you are able to supply any number of inputs to the AND gate and OR gate, then all the equations of the carries can be generated in only 2 levels. Then the carry generation part will take only 2 units of time to generate the carries ahead of time. This we can exploit to generate the sum and carry together for all the bits in the carry look ahead adder. This is the circuit for carry look ahead generation. C0 is 0 and we are able to generate this G0, P0, all this G1, P1 in 1 unit of time after we supply AIs and BIs. And this we can use it with AND gates. See here, the number of inputs for this AND gate is only 2. And here we have 3, here we have 4. And this will increase as the number of bits is more. And the number of AND gates is also here only 1. Here we have 2 AND gates. And here we have 3. And the next bit will have 4 AND gates and so on. And similarly, the number of inputs to the OR gate. Here only we have 2 inputs, here we have 3 inputs, here 4 inputs and so on. This will also grow. But what is the advantage that we have? All the carry bits can be generated in 2 units of time. After we get this inputs, which can be generated at time T1, outputs of AND gates, all the AND gates here can be generated at time T2, and this carries can be generated at time T3. Okay, so this is the advantage of the carry generator. This is the circuit of carry look ahead adder. We supply A and B and we have the XOR gate to generate the PI terms and we have the AND gate to generate the generate term GIs. And this we can, so inside this we have the carry look ahead generator, which is going to take 2 units of time to generate the outputs C1, C2, C3 and C4. So here we have 1 unit of time to generate this one, we have 2 units of time to generate this carry, and then in so 3 units of time, so at the 4th unit of time we'll be able to generate all the bits in the output S0 to C4, and this is irrespective of any number of bits. Even if we here we have designed for 4 bits, even if we extend the operation of the addition to 8 bits long, the amount of time that we require will not change. In 4 units of time, we will be able to generate the result after we supply the input. Thus, the delay in the addition of bits in the binary adder is reduced in carry look ahead adder.